roll out a recipe on Cup of Joe, powered by NP Gas. Ignite your passion. All right, time to roll out a recipe. It's powered by NP Gas. This morning, we are so happy that he took time to roll out a recipe and spend some time with us. Kes Deffenthaler is in the building this morning.
Yes. Looking very interesting.
We have rolled out a recipe or two.
Yes.
We had a drink or two.
Sangria, I remember.
We did a sangria, I think we did.
Baileys.
Yeah. Ooh, she remembered. Yeah, it was a homemade Baileys.
Yes.
It was a homemade Baileys.
Good stuff.
It made the cookbook, I think. Nice. That recipe is in the cookbook. This morning, do you do chow?
Yes, of course. You know, you grow up with chow.
Mango chow.
Yeah, fruit trees.
Chow. Yeah. We chow in anything.
Yeah.
So, you know, your boy palate got a little elevated. What we can chow? So, shrimp. I got some wonderful shrimp from Ocean Delight. And I said, I wonder if this shrimp, I was thinking a shrimp cocktail, then I was thinking ceviche.
Yes.
And I said, that sounds like a chow.
And
that's what we're doing this morning.
Nice.
We're doing a shrimp.
I love that.
And pineapple chow. All the ingredients for a chow right here. And Kes is just going to put all this together. We have some kusumain in the fridge. But first thing, I think one of the most important ingredients in chow, Kes.
Yes, it's grass.
the grass is the most important ingredient.
Yes. So big up to the almighty Shadow Benny.
And all the grass.
Yes.
Pepper.
You don't know. Greatness.
So all the ingredients for Kes Carnival is right,
it's right here.
So they say you're responsible for chopping the grass.
No problem.
A nice fine chop on the Shadow Benny.
While I am
going to just kind of pull all the ingredients together. So guys, This is poached shrimp. Boiling water. You dump the shrimp in the boiling water for no longer than about a minute. Salt and pepper, and that's it. You take the shrimp out. You can put it in a cold bath if you so wish, but you know, just boil it. Don't overcook the shrimp, please, because you will spoil.
Don't overdo it.
We have some cucumbers here. I love cucumbers in chow.
Yes.
I don't think I just like cucumbers in chow.
I think it's interesting to, you know, clear the palate a little bit, you know?
Yeah. So I get some cucumbers in there. And the pineapples. I just thought shrimp, pineapple, we thought that would have been a good combination.
A little bit of sweetness.
Yes.
A little bit of sweetness.
You know the tea.
Yes.
So these are the main ingredients. I just want to get kind of everybody get to know each other. Let the shrimp meet the cucumber, the pineapple, get accustomed to the shrimp. And everybody in one nice big...
I'm coming.
You're coming?
I know. Just get it as fine as possible.
That's properly chopped.
We all right?
Because you do cook.
Yes, I love to cook.
I heard a story that you took for the very first time in Panorama. You cook and you bubble the pilau.
I bubble the pilau and I cook it, and you know, and I felt proud. You know, I felt like grown folk. You know,
you felt like a big man.
Yeah. I cook a pilau.
I bring the pilau for Panorama this year. You know,
I was responsible for the after meal. You know, after the destruction. But no, it was great. You know, and I enjoy cooking. It's relaxing to me. You know, it's something I really enjoy, and I just enjoy good food, soul food, you know.
Yeah. Mom used to allow you guys to cook?
She's the one who taught me, you know.
Yeah.
I definitely came up to, I had to ask her, you know what I mean? I was like, Mommy, this guy's making stunts around me, cooking for my girlfriend, and I need to be able to cook better than him. So,
true story
for me. And thought curry was my first meal, you know.
Right.
She said it was the simplest thing to learn first, and then, you know, I'd move on to stew, and I cook. I love it.
You cook.
Yes.
All right, so I have another most important ingredient is
garlic.
The garlic. We grated it nicely and nice and fine.
Garlic and salt.
Garlic.
Nice.
you go in. Salt and pepper.
Right. I would put it for taste, you know. I think there's no salt in here yet. So
the shrimp probably just lightly salted. So we salt and pepper. The good thing about this as well is that when you taste and when it kusumes a little bit and comes together,
you can add.
So you can add.
Of course.
We have some fresh lime juice that we also want to just get in here. Could add more. We have some fresh one. So if you give me a nice little squeeze here.
Another wrong.
Cool. freshness. That adds an important freshness to it.
Definitely.
And my brother, pepper. Hot like pepper.
Pepper in a pepper. Let's go.
We're going straight in. I told you, let's chop that up fine. Boy. Some people like it. Get ready. Fine. Some people like it.
You know? It depends on how you like your pepper. You know?
Depends on how you like your pepper.
Don't eat that, boy. Yes.
Nice. And you mix that together.
Save the grass for last. I like
Save
that.
Save the grass for last. Yes. Use a rhyme every time you
talk. Yeah, well, you know, it's just songs and it's just rolling.
Kes, this is
amazing. Amazing.
You allow this, as I said, to kusume.
To set almost, you know? Definitely. Smell. A blend between a chow and a ceviche.
That's what it is, huh?
Very cool.
That's what it is.
Yes.
Shrimp and pineapple salad, guys. This one is the one to try. Get a recipe on trinicooks.com. Kes and I sit down after. We talk Tuesday on the rocks because it's coming up Tuesday.
Mm-hmm.
It's Tuesday.
Yes. Don't know.
It's Tuesday. Come on back. Roll out a recipe. Courtesy of the folks at NP Cooking Gas. Roll out a recipe on Cup of Joe. Powered by NP Gas. Ignite your passion.